So hopefully you've practiced enough that you will now understand the algorithm. Let's try to explain this algorithm. All that changes is that a vector of integers is passed into the algorithm, and that vector we march through from top to bottom. And in the current iteration, we expose one component of that vector, and that component of that vector is going to be overwritten with an integer that indicates with which row we need to swap. Now let's make a picture so that we can understand what's going on. At the typical step, we've gotten to this point in the matrix. We're already finished with these parts right here. We've partially updated this part right here. Now, we repartition. Previously, what we would have done is simply taken this entry and divided it into that entry, and then done an outer product of these two parts of the matrix, updating this part of the matrix by subtracting it off. What is different now is that if we encounter a zero here, we've got a problem. So the first thing we do is we look at all of these entries, and we find the first one that is not zero. If this entry is not equal to zero, then we will say we have to swap with the row index with the zero because it's relative to the current row. If this entry is not zero, but this first entry was, then we will return one, etc. And to determine which entry is the first entry that's not zero, we have this function called pivot. Once we've determined with which row we need to swap, we need to actually permute those two rows. We need to swap those two rows. We need to pivot them, whatever you want to call it. Now that is just a matter of applying the pivot matrix that is determined by this index that we just computed to this part of the matrix, which is that part of the matrix. Once we've done that, we simply proceed exactly as we did before with our LU factorization algorithm. Here's a recap. We start with a matrix, and we would like to make that into an upper triangular matrix with the multipliers filled in below the diagonal. The first thing we do is we compute what permutation needs to happen. In this case, the current row doesn't need to be swapped with any row at all, so this is just an identity. Next, we apply a Gauss transform. Once we've done that, we compute another permutation. It turned out that we had to swap the second and the last row. After that, we compute another permutation. What we end up with once we have done all of that computation is an upper triangular matrix with below it the multipliers. And we can think of this as representing a matrix L times U that is equal to the original matrix A. But now actually it is not equal to the original matrix A. Why? Because in the process of doing our computation, we did these permutations. So what really happened is that you've computed the LU factorization of a permuted matrix A, where P here represents a permutation matrix. So that's the magic, okay? You can think of it as you have this matrix, and if you had a crystal ball, you would have known that you really should have reordered these rows. And had you reordered those rows, then LU, without pivoting, without doing all of this row swapping, would have worked just fine. And we would have ended up with a lower triangular matrix times an upper triangular matrix. What happens is that in the process of performing our LU with partial pivoting, we are placing the rows in the right order, and lo and behold, we still end up with an LU factorization, but now not of the original matrix, but of a matrix that has had its rows swapped. So the net effect is the same as if you swapped it up front, but you're actually doing it as part of the algorithm as you find out that you need to swap rows.